Hello, photography students. Here I am in the Morrisville High School woodworking technology education room, and I've taken a lot of pictures of this place. Turn that flash off. I don't need it. I've taken lots of pictures of this room. I've had lots of students take pictures of this room over and over and over again over all the years that we've offered digital photography here at Morrisville. How can you make that picture interesting? How can you improve your photographic eye? Well, composition is the real key way of doing that. And that's a lesson we're going to be heading into. That's our next thing. But composition is a term we hear it in English class. You're writing composition. We hear it in music class. The famous composers like Beethoven who arrange musical notes. You, as a photographer, are arranging the visual elements within the frame of your picture. I am arranged, and all the other stuff here is arranged within this picture. Now, did I spend a lot of time planning this out? Not necessarily. I could stand over here, I could stand over here. It's a little bit distracting because there's a lot of stuff in this room, right? I really want you to focus on me, I could have had a plain background. I've done that for some of the videos for my classes where I've gone and filmed somewhere else. It depends on what kind of a story and message you're trying to send in your picture, how you want your pictures to turn out. All right, so that's the next thing we're going to be moving into. The assignment I'm going to have you guys do is I'm going to have you take 5 pictures of the same place, either of the same room, or go outside and pick a spot but take 5 pictures of that place, and make sure they're all different. We're going to use those pictures to facilitate our conversation about composition. I actually had a friend that went to art school for photography. His assignment on a college level was to take 100 pictures of the same room. All of them had to be different. So I know you can meet the challenge of taking 5 pictures of the same place. All right? The second piece of that assignment, which is an important step in this virtual photography class, is I want you to download those pictures from your phone. Everyone may have to do something a little different. You may have to plug your phone in to transfer them. You may have to email them from your phone to your email account and open them that way. I'm not sure what you're gonna have to do, but try it out. If you can't figure out how to get your pictures from your camera, from your cell phone to your computer, you can shoot me an email, talk to one of your classmates, talk to somebody in your house that is tech savvy. Let's try and get this figured out because that's going to be an important step to moving forward.